about to go and get registered, I think. Sign in to climb up. Strict baggage limits are enforced. The porters carry no more than 15 kilos. The rest is up to us. And now after weeks and weeks of gearing up, we'll soon find out whether we bought exactly what we need, too much, not enough, but there's no going back. It's 6 days up the hill now, and so let's see what happens. Well, here we are. This is the Kilimanjaro starting gate, the China gate, and we've had to just do it in the hut behind me. We had to take on water, minimum 3 liters. They recommend 5, but we're planning on 3. Oh, here we go. We're taking a break. We've climbed for perhaps 2 hours. We're halfway. 1,000 meter climb today, and welcome to lunchtime. And this is where we spend the night. Two-man tent. We'll roll out our bed rolls, blow up our mattresses, and hopefully we'll sleep. There's an ache through the legs. How was today?
Today was
easy. Breeze.
Well, I had a tough time just coming up to lunchtime. Got a bad headache.
Did
wasn't
you?
Wasn't feeling so good.
Then was that the pressure of the rucksack? You think?
Don't know.
Kind of less height, in fact, tomorrow.
Yeah, less height, but it's steeper. Today we have to climb about 800 vertical meters. Now, perhaps that stretches out over 8-9 kilometers. Now, whilst it doesn't sound a lot, it's a lot steeper than it was yesterday. And so I think today will be the first really testing day. So we'll just trudge up the hill, slowly, slowly.
It's cold and we're at 4,000 metres. We're having a great time.
Down at the base there, okay, of the glaciers.
Yeah.
Behind that peak is Moenzi.
That is Moenzi.
And how old is that?
5,149.
And the Shira Plateau over there, that was the...
oldest.
That's the oldest.
Yeah.
Wow. So we're heading up there. That was Arnold, a man who we were lucky enough to have had as our head guide, and who had already summited over 100 times. With an easygoing nature, effortless charm, and a ready smile, Arnold seemed to make the very difficult seem ridiculously easy. Yesterday when I woke up, I thought, if I feel this bad tomorrow, I can't go on. As far as the whole of the group is concerned, nearly everyone felt the effects of altitude. Headache, usually. Sleepless night for a lot of people last night. A couple of people were vomiting. That's the reality. It's not a gentle trek. It's arduous and it does takes its toll on your body, you know. And now we have to climb up what seems like a sheer rock face, and the first few hours today is going to be very tough.
Yeah, it will be a good day, but it's tough and long day.
Almost 16 hours.
Considering I didn't sleep, I feel pretty well. So we'll just have to see and see how we feel at the next stop, because we'll only know really whether we get altitude sickness at the next stop. We could be chucking our guts up at the next camp, and then we're basically not going up. I gather it's only the people who don't have headaches and don't feel nauseous who are carrying on to the summit, so fingers crossed.
Better than the first two nights, although didn't have full proper sleep. I feel more refreshed today. Still tired. Everything feels like an effort. Even thinking, organizing things, packing, everything takes ages. I think I'm one of the last to get out. I feel okay.
It's hard, but you go slow, so it's okay. Yeah, you don't get too, it's not too bad. And it's nice because you get to take in the scenery, and it's really, really beautiful.
Great. Unbelievable.